Hey, Grammar Hawk. Mashing A buttons so fast, but Link does not want to put away the sword fast enough. Does this without, like, adjusting. Because it never works for me unless I adjust. Also, Link is swinging really slowly. There we go. because my hands are kind of cold, but I don't know, that shouldn't be a problem anywhere else. World record is 2:14:52, I believe. .204 is the N64 version world record time. Oh, is it not submitted? I thought when they made the page everything automatically transferred over, but I guess not. My time's like really bad anyway. Wait, no, that was the way I shouldn't have done it. Nobody really runs MST in this game actively. MST is Medallion Stones Trials. Basically, beat all the temples and beat all the trials, and then beat Ganon.
Ha 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 ha!
Now you can Wesson 3D. We can't do it, well, we can do it off the Kakariko fence, but it's weird. It's not as easy to get the recoil as it is in the original game. Like, we can't get the recoil in Kokiri Forest. Otherwise, we probably wouldn't do it that way. We'd probably still do TSC. But we're not going to Kakariko anyway, because we have to get Zelda's Lullaby first. Yeah, West Escape probably does work, but it's almost impossible to get the recoil, basically. Because recoiling was nerfed in 3D. And it doesn't work in as many places. That's because no one's ever done West Escape in 3D. If you could do it, you'd probably have to do it with a stick somehow. Honestly, it doesn't really matter which one you play first. I would probably recommend playing this one first, though, because I personally like it better. Because casually, this game has much faster text, which is nice. English text on VC takes so long. Ah! Nice walk. Actually, it doesn't matter because we come into the zone standing anyway. Stop. Oh my god, really? Link just has to target everything. Would have been fine if I didn't retarget on that one. Oh well. ISG's not viable. Only really for puzzle races. And I guess for no IM / wrong warp. Other than that, nothing really. I mean, it's not really viable because of the way that it's done. It's not viable because if you put your sword away, it gets cancelled. Also, this wolf is really wasting my time right now. While you have it, to do any like bomb hovering or anything, because that puts your sword away. Although it is possible to get ISG with a broken Deku stick, and then using that, when you put away a broken Deku stick, there's no put away animation, so you still have ISG, I believe. Broken Deku stick is so hard to get, and trying to get ISG with it is like the same as regular ISG, which is already really hard to get. So, again, it's not very viable. And plus, you'd only really be able to do it as a child. Hey, Zelda Cubed. Oh, I forgot to split for Saria's song. But we were way ahead because my PB got bottle, and so skipping bottle is going to save a bunch of time. That cutscene skip saves a few seconds because it makes this cycle good. And because it skips having to actually watch the cutscene.
Ah!
Hey, Paul the Bucket. And yeah, the textures in this game are a real upgrade from the N64 version. Let's see if we can do this room correctly this time. There we go. That's how we go fast. And then don't get hit by keys. So well. So that splits blue. Sometimes especially when it forces me to waste bombs. So now I can't Hess here. Hey, Bigfoot. Oh god, no wrong warp. Please. The wrong warp is an interesting category though, but banning wrong warp kind of makes this game uninteresting. And that's gonna lead me into the house, so let's not go that way. Hopefully I can get some bombs in the grass. Yeah, all the categories in this game, except for like any percent new game plus, are all pretty fun to run. I guess we're getting a lot of rupees. I probably will return to SS sometime. I don't know about MM3D though. Because my Skyward Sword time can go down by like 10 minutes or something. Like, I should be able to get at least, like, sub-5-10, if anything. Any percent and any percent new game plus is that they're basically the same, like it's basically the beginning of every single category that you do. So it's good to do any percent and any percent new game plus, like if you're just starting to learn this game, but after that there isn't really any point because you'll basically be doing an any percent run at the beginning of every single category. Except glitchless. I killed Wind Waker HD. Well, we can still find storage in Wind Waker HD. That'll spice it up a little bit. Oops. Why is the camera turning like that? I'm running out of bombs. If there was no RNG in Wind Waker HD, then it would be a much better speed game. There'd probably be more people running it. But the RNG kind of kills it. Once your time gets lower and lower. So someone can figure out how to take out all the RNG in Wind Waker HD, I would, like, pay you money to do that. And I'd be happy to go for like 357 or 356. Well, the one hard thing about this game is cutscene skips and wrong warps at the end of temples. That's the only annoying part of the runs most of the time. And then occasionally you'll have like some really hard trick you need to pull off. It's like I feel like every Zelda game has like one thing that like is absolutely awful for speedrunning, but everything else kind of like makes up for it. Let's see, Wind Waker has Super Swimming, Wind Waker HD has Sail RNG. Skyward Sword is just simply really long. I guess OOT doesn't really have one. Or MM, unless you count, what is it? Unless you count the fact that the controls are kind of meh, in my opinion, but that's an opinionated thing. And then Twilight Princess has Bit and Gorge Void. But Gorge Void could be killed, potentially. I'm gonna save here, because bomb count is kind of precious. Well, that didn't go as planned. Yeah, if you could buffer OOT3D like MM3D, then OOT3D would be perfect. Like, oh my god. I just didn't a Link Between Worlds run because I had been practicing it recently and I needed to test the 3DS capture card. Like, I ended up learning the whole Link Between Worlds any percent route, but never actually did any runs. Ah. Come on. Stuff. Even though I failed the mega flip once, I'm still gonna save a lot of time. Still needed to have bombs equipped, but oh well. Oh, nice. Got the early cutscene. Well, I mean, I'm pretty sure Zelda U is going to be a really long speedrun. Definitely. Like, let's see, like, in my opinion, a perfect, or like a quote-unquote good Zelda speed game. We'll have tricks that are hard but aren't like you miss it, but aren't like 50-50 as to whether you miss tricks or not. So it still has some challenge, and it's around 2.5 to 3 hours long. So if Wind Waker got storage and barrier skip, Wind Waker would be pretty good. Yeah, this is my second 3DS capture card. No, we still got hover boots, this child. We don't in 100%, but we do in MST and all dungeons. Amazing how this game does not like to give you bombs. I'm gonna do mega flip. That's not the way to mega flip. Oh! No, we're not gonna do Puppet Ganon skip an RTA. We're not making Wind Waker retarded like that. Barrier skip would be really good for Task, because Task could easily do Puppet Ganon skip. No, it's completely RNG dependent. It takes, well, I mean, because the keys has to knock you in the correct direction to get into the loading zone. That's what actually took so many tries. You don't really have to skip Puppet Ganon either. You can do Puppet Ganon fine, and then you can use the fairy to zombie hover up to the top where you actually need to get to. Please work. Okay. Sometimes bombs don't like to blow up rocks, and it's really annoying. Not playing a bonus song. That's why Trog tried really hard to get a fake death hover that you could potentially do to get to the top, because once you restore your hearts, or once you hit continue out of a fake death hover, you get restored to 3 hearts, and you can just continue on to the loading zone. I believe that you get a bow and quiver if you get light arrows, along with the other 2 arrow types. Oops. Although I might be wrong about that. Hello, Calculicious. Wait, what? Why can't you get light arrows? Oh, that's right. Well, no, because, I mean, anyway you go to Hyrule, you're going to be getting the Master Sword anyway. Because you'll either do EMS. Well, okay, well, that's a special exception, but you'd either be doing EMS or you'd be going to Hyrule 1 and pulling out the Master Sword. Ow. So we have 3 bombs or 4 bombs? Something along the lines of that. Anyway, it's nighttime and there are still people here. Now we're gonna take the long, arduous trek to Shadow Temple. Thank you. No, you can get Nehru's Pearl without beating DRC or Forbidden Woods. But if you get it before beating Forbidden Woods, then you end up softlocking because Coral tries to bring you back to the nearest quadrant. Get to Hyrule without three pearls by doing EMS, but since you didn't go to Hyrule 1, you didn't activate the Hyrule 1 flag, which is necessary, and I split late, but whatever. No, I'm not going for world record right now. Probably not for a while if I stick with this category, even. I'd still have to improve at this game more to even, like, be good enough to maybe get it. Also, it would have been nice if I didn't lose a minute to escape, but whatever. Yeah, there's also a weird chest storage clip you can do with the grapple hook that I actually didn't know about until like a week ago when I was randomly testing stuff. For the GameCube version, the world record holder is Chaotic Ace with 357.59. English isn't faster, it's just that I'm too lazy to switch over to Spanish, and Spanish saves like maybe 2 or 3 seconds or something. It honestly doesn't really matter which language you use. Well, as far as I know, nothing ever really came of it. I mean, we sort of were able to figure out why it happened. But we don't, like, we're not entirely sure as to what causes it to happen. But we can reproduce it. Well, 2 seconds over a 2 hour time period doesn't matter. If it's 2 seconds over a 5 second time period, then yes, it matters. Where am I going? Oh yeah, Kakariko. Hmm, we can save 2 minutes on this split. Well, yes, 2 seconds can make a difference. In that sense, at least. Also, I need more bombs. Well, no, you can make jokes like that, but I don't know, that's just kind of what I say. No, Bongo is the guy who bangs on the drums. King Dodongo is the boss of Dodongo's Cavern. Or no, Bongo Bongo bangs on the drums. think that was too early. Nope. You can skip the tingle bottle text. What does that mean? Like the text of you getting the tingle bottle? Or what? Wait, so you're saying we can skip the entire tingle bottle cutscene? Oh wait, roll to the door. So we can't open the door. Or I don't know, I'm confused. If you can make a video, that would be cool. Because I don't know, maybe there are other, like, random uses of the Pro Controller that we don't know about. Turn, not exit. Aaron, thanks for the good luck. Damage. Hey. Well, no, you can still use the gamepad even if you have the pro controller selected. Like, that's the weird thing. Well, I know you can still use it for equips, but I haven't, like, tested if you could actually use it to control Link. If someone knows, they can say. Considered being a radio host. No. But I know people have said that you can equip before, so I assumed that was true. Goma to Trollrova. We're gonna have to go with Dampay on that one. Die at the same time as you equip magic armor? I don't know. I think you'd still die. Because you don't actually die in Wind Waker. Ouch. Ah, dang it. Like, in Moonbrick, you don't actually die until after the animation where Link gets up again. So I have to get hearts now. Hopefully I won't get trolled in the process. Although I think I'll probably be fine, but we'll have to see. Hit it! Wait, please. But hey, we got the S. Well, the roll clip was first discovered in HD. The problem with roll clipping in the beginning is that we assumed it only worked in HD because we thought that it was a factor from the default roll speed being increased in HD, which it wasn't. And it worked perfectly fine in SD, except you just don't jump in SD. Hold down, and that worked, so we're gonna hold down. I don't think you can roll clip out of Orca's house with a pot. I know you can get storage off of Orca and SD because if you mash his text fast enough. Which is another one of those weird occurrences where you can get storage. Thank you. I think the fake one is still in there, so I could have dropped a bomb on it. God, Beta Quest 3DS. Well, we already had that built-in feature. It's called Death Hole Rung Warp. I have a purple 3DS. Alright, great RNG. Thank you, Volvagia. So I need hookshot on two, bombs and Ferrari's wind. Yeah. Got a split for that. I like chips also. When did I split for Forest Temple in my PB? Are on Y. Okay, yeah, that was supposed to happen. I got confused for a second. God dang it. Miscounted. thought I just needed one more. It's okay, though. It's not the end of the world. I think that's all I needed. All right. Good stuff. So now, hookshot, upper boots, Furray's wind, yeah. Completed Minish Cap. I got to like the second dungeon and just kind of gave up.
Thank you.
No, I didn't get bottle. This is my first ever run that skips bottle. Not sure if that's exactly where I split in my PB. Also, nice grab. But I guess that's where I'm splitting now. Oh, oops, forgot I could go the other way. Turned on Moon Jump when it was released. Grezzo flicked the switch in the debug ROM. Just get a heart. These guys do not want to let up. Oh, come on. Please don't respawn. Okay, good. Yeah, I already beat the Forest Temple. I just need to get the bow. To set the thingy. That would be a bad thing to forget. Side out is too hard. Of course I only get one small thing of magic and I get like a million hearts. Dude, why am I always getting second frame? It's annoying. Please. This should not be this hard. And there's the magic we needed. Why am I getting second frame? This has never been a problem before, and suddenly I'm losing minutes to it. Come on. There you go. And of course I missed it somehow. So I guess we'll be trying again. Hit the hookshot jumps perfectly. I don't know anymore. Where is this thing? Because clearly this is not working. This is such a problem. It really shouldn't be. Ugh, come on. Why is it so hard to get out sometimes? Where is it? I've always followed just going straight back, and that's always worked, except for now. Because of course we're in the middle of a really good run, so this is the perfect time for it to start screwing me over. What? Where is this thing? If I can't get it by these last two times, then I'm just gonna do the tree the regular way, because clearly this is not working. What is going on? Of course. Let's let him get it on the last possible attempt. Pretty sure arrows work on this guy. I guess not. Saved. Not before I lost 5.5 minutes, though. Because OOT3D is better, Kappa. Skip Goron Bryce in Master Quest. Although no one really cares about Master Quest in this game, so. Oh well. If only there was a Bomb Chew chest in Jabu we could get. Going to be archived on YouTube if I PB, yeah. If I don't PB, it'll just be a past broadcast for like 3 months. Save another 5 minutes, no. Why are they always on separate sides of the stage? Good luck trying to find a way to manipulate RNG, but if you do, good job. wonder if there's a way to skip this cutscene. Oh well. So we're gonna lose time on Shadow Temple. Actually, no, let's not split there. Frame too early. Although this cutscene's pretty short, so it's okay. No, this is MST. This is not 100%. Alright, good night, Eagle Eye. Oh, I needed hook shot out. Actually, I could probably use arrows. Cycle kind of meh, but whatever. Thank you. Now we have to wait through this cutscene, though. So yeah, this cutscene kind of takes forever. I know, right? Sheik is Zeldo. Who would have guessed? Aaron, please. I think Zelda's pretty good in Skyward Sword. Shh. Okay, the 4.5 minute cutscene is over. Finally. So close to working. Oh well. We gave it a shot. It just turned slightly too early. Oy. Really? Otherwise I would have had that. No, Light Arrow cutscene is not skippable. Pretty sure Link and Zelda are both teenagers, so it makes sense. Have Zelda act like a teenager. Even though she's acted like a wise character before. You really had to push her. The run, for the most part, was good, and then kind of lost 5 minutes at Deku Tree for an unknown reason. Oh, come on. Well, now I have to wait.
Come on.
Yeah, I know about the hammer slide. Why am I getting second frame, dude? This is like unacceptable. Oh, come on, really? Gonna grab the corner like that? Oh wait, was it the... must have been the one on the very right. Or on the very left, god dang it. Yep, Water Temple is after trials. It's weird, but it's the fastest way to do it. Alright, so now we have three more trials. As long as I can get the Hess in fire, it'll be fine. Not the Hess, the Fess. What? Oh, that's a nice backflip, Link. I want to avoid taking damage. Huh? did. Well, doesn't N64 skip gold gauntlets now? Because they can, like, grab into the one in the fire temple. Not the fire temple, the fire trial. And they can super slide through the other one in a light trial. To defeat all the enemies here, I think. Bloody. Yeah. Okay. Next one, we play Zelda's Lullaby, and then we go through those stupid maze thing. Oh, it's slower. Dang. This one. No. Ugh, really? I knew it was one of them, at least. Alright, well, that's the trials. Early explosives! Oh my god! Whoa! Yeah. Early explosives is a thing if you have New Game Plus. And it's possible in Master Quest mode without New Game Plus. Wait, we go from here, right? I think we go from here. Yeah, play Bolero. All right, good. I'm gonna drop in the water, so I don't take damage. Yeah, you get gold scotulas and cross the River of Sand. Or you can cross the River of Sand and go to Spirit Temple and get them. But scotulas is probably faster. I need to do that anyway, but that's... Well, no, never mind. It isn't. Morpho's a waterbender. Spooky. There's the heart piece. There it is. First one was too early, second one was too late. Is Aaron getting bopped? Take it! Zelda, hurry. Plot twist. Suddenly Link dies and we have to speedrun Zelda 1. I've never seen this actually done before. I mean, I've seen this done, but like... I don't think that was done correctly. Was it 5 side hops? It was... wait. Oh, I just wasn't to the left enough. Oh well, I guess I'm getting my sword knocked away. That the Master Sword actually, like, gets knocked back in this fight. Oops. This image. Oh, okay. Well, yay, we PB'd in MST by 3 minutes and 37 seconds. Would have been a true meme if we'd PB'd by 10 minutes more, but I think we can save that for another time. Why is the Chamber of Sages so dark? Is it supposed to be this dark? Oh well. Thanks, Aaron. Yeah, we'll just PB again and save 6 minutes at Deku Tree. That'll be easy. If I can figure out what I was doing wrong. Oof. Well, no, there were multiple bad splits, but the worst split was definitely Deku Tree. Let's see, like, Escape was bad. Zelda's Letter was okay, I guess. Saria's Song. I missed the fest there, so I can save time there. I missed the second Hellfire skip twice on bombs. Jabu. What did I miss there? Oh well. I didn't save all the time I could save there. And then Zora's Sapphire, I missed the Mega Flip once. Master Sword was... Well, I can save time on Master Sword by doing Ledge Cancel, or by doing A Slide, but I'm not doing A Slide. That split was pretty good, I would think. Enter Fire Temple was fine. Fire Temple was okay. Got the Hess. Although I did have to get extra hearts at one point. Forest Temple was fine. Deku Tree, I think we know what went wrong. Spirit Temple missed cutscene skip, Shadow Temple missed cutscene skip. Trials was kinda okay for my first time without bottle. Can definitely improve Shadow Trial. Water Temple was good, Ganon was fine. Yeah, it's a treasure sphere from Wind Waker. It's the new sub-emote.